When did masculinity become something bad? As I sit here with ripped jeans and my legs crossed.
maybe when all us men decided that we would accept that characterization of it.
I never accepted it. I mean, like, I remember growing up, right? And I think I saw it like play out in movies. Like, I remember growing up and I remember seeing like
TV too. TV. It went from My Three Sons and Father Knows Best to
dude.
Well,
to what are the
to every father being a buffoon.
Yeah. I'm literally watching movies and I'm like, okay, Bruce Willis is saving the day, right? And then like 90s, Bruce Willis is still saving the day. And then it's 2000s. I'm like, do we have nobody new here? Is Bruce Willis still the only f-ing man left saving the god?
Okay, I'm going to explain it very easily, okay? These concepts are what you make of them. Masculinity could be a trait that you associate with like being confident, for example, or being brave or whatever the where versus when we talk about like toxic masculinity, it is a bastardized version of masculinity when insecure people that want to portray themselves as masculine will engage in acts that hurt themselves. That's it. Like, for example, people being like, I'm such a manly man, brother. Look at the big fat fucking steak that I have. Like, it's clown shit. Okay. That's what toxic masculinity is. You're not fucking brave. You're not a leader. You're not like actually fucking doing any masculine things. You're just looking like a clown ass. But other insecure people are also responding to that with their lizard brains and assuming that like you're a fucking masculine person. Absolutely zero people will be like, oh my God, the male hero saved the fucking babies from an orphanage. That's toxic masculinity. It's not that, which is precisely why a lot of people who want to make this criticism will turn around and act like that's what fucking people are upset about. And I say this as someone who is pretty fucking masculine, okay? There's just a difference between like what you make of masculinity and what you consider to be toxic masculinity.
And then all of a sudden, like these like Michael Cera types, he could be a sweet guy, but he's playing like this imp guy, you know, who's just being like walked around on a leash by his girl in every movie.
Yeah, good got to be synonymous with harmless.
I don't think that you can make that a trend. I can't speak on behalf of chicks, but I don't think that you can like make chicks like beta males.
I love that we treat Jordan Peterson as like this brilliant fucking intellectual, and he's having a conversation with fucking Andrew Schultz, and he's like, yeah, you're making quite the profound point right now, Andrew, about how bitches don't be wanting to fuck beta males. Dog, you're literally having, again, this goes back to like the Joe Rogan thing that we were talking about earlier, where it's like, you're literally having the fucking conversation that like me and my homies had when we were 20 years old, sitting around on a fucking hot couch, okay? Sitting on a leather couch that's too hot, having this conversation in a living room. This is not like some profound revelation, but to all the idiots who watch this shit, they see the college professor saying things that they agree with and they're like, oh, this guy must be fucking brilliant. The things that he's talking about are incredible. Also, I love the fucking masculine, like, norms, gender norms, or what is decidedly masculine being talked about by someone like Jordan Peterson, who does cry from time to time when he thinks about the fall of Western civilization and men, which normally would be something that is like beta by the same metrics that they rigorously apply to standards, who isn't very masculine at all. I mean, he's a fucking college professor. The outdated, antiquated way of like thinking about masculine features does not apply to Jordan Peterson.
Well, you know, the one of the ones you already discussed is competence.
See, that's what I'm saying. It's like competence. Why is competence a masculine feature? I literally don't understand that. Like, is femininity like not competent? Is it incompetent? Like, why is competence a masculine feature? The thing that that's why I said, like, it's what you associate with it. People just make that up as they go along, right? You're just making it up. Like, competence is completely removed from masculinity. How the fuck could you sit here and be like, no, competence is actually biologically a trait associated with men and masculinity? Like, why? Unless your point literally is, well, women are incompetent. Competence is an attractive feature. It's removed from masculinity, though. Maybe you don't understand because it's too feminine. In whose eyes? That's the other question. It's like, you look to someone like myself, for example, someone who is 6 foot fucking four, 260 pounds, who eats 2 pounds of straight white chicken breast every fucking day, which, by the way, those are not my standards of masculinity. Those are your standards of masculinity, and you say, I am too beta in comparison to fucking Jordan Peterson. Like, who decides this then? Is it just you? How are you going to sit here and be like, Ben Shapiro is significantly more masculine than fucking HasanAbi, dude? Are you kidding me? Motherfucker walks around in a sports coat with elbow pads. You know what I mean? Come on, dude.
Confuse competence with power, then you punish competence. And maybe then you become attracted to weakness because it's not authoritarian. It doesn't look like tyranny, but that's only because competence and power are confused in your mind.
Competence and power. Yeah, there's this thing with power.
Yeah, that's for sure. There's this claim that all of our institutions are based on power. It's like, no, they're not. Only when they're corrupt is that true.
Wait, what are they based on then?
Has anybody that you've studied throughout history managed to obtain a significant amount of power and done the right thing with it?
Well, I think most of our institutions that function reasonably well do that reasonably well, or had.
Like what? I need to know. What do you mean by that?
But there's a huge difference between Joseph Stalin and Franklin Roosevelt.
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay. What does that mean? I don't understand. He doesn't ever say anything. The thing I don't understand about Jordan Peterson is why people think he's so profound, because he just like reaches to the energy of a certain argument without fully subscribing to it ever. And he'll just keep making cyclical arguments over and over again, like cyclical points over and over again, which is like, you know, there's a difference between Joseph Stalin and Franklin Delano Roosevelt. I mean, you get it. Why? What is that? How does that have to do with like power? Or people who have like institutional power that don't go corrupt. What does that even have to do with like power in general? Because ultimately democracy or every sort of governance literally revolves around the distribution of power. That's just what it is. So for him to say like, well, these are not about power, I don't understand how you can make that argument and then not even make an argument and continue on with a difference between FDR and Stalin.
Look at the Democratic West, all things considered.
Yeah.
The leadership has been okay to good.
I mean, FDR did fucking put, I mean, the camps were not a great demonstration of power.
Well, you have a car.
Yeah.
Does it work?
Yeah.
How often?
Currently, every time I use it.
So like if you use it 1,000 times, how many times doesn't it work?
0 out of 1,000. A car, right? You said car.
Yeah, a car.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, well, that institution is doing pretty well.
Yeah, because I'm
not... It has a 99.9% success rate. Have you crashed yet when you flew?
I mean, I think you're jinxing me, but no.
And they're so safe, it's just beyond comprehension.
How does this have anything to do with masculinity or the democratic process? What the fuck? What is he saying? I don't understand, dude. Maybe I'm too stupid, but I feel like that's not the case. I feel like the apple cider has rotted his brain to the core. Jordan Peterson fans are like Christopher Nolan fans in the sense that Jordan Peterson will have a fucking brain dead take on completely unrelated subjects that he like somehow acts like they're tied together. His fanboys would be like, ha, you simpleton, you fool. You simply do not have the processing power to understand the incredible take that Jordan Peterson had here.
With you, I'm not upset at like institutions in that. I'm talking about like a human being that is compelled to power. Like I understand certain people being compelled to greatness. That's really cool. You see it in athletes.
And what's
right?
The difference? What's the difference?
I think there's something about people who desire power instead of greatness. And I think that power comes with greatness. But if your desire is power, I think there is something dangerous there because you're willing to do whatever it is to maintain that power. Whereas
it's the mimicry of greatness. It's the mimicry of greatness. Oh. Greatness deserves power because you want the powerful to be you want the great to be powerful. Why wouldn't you?
Oh, that's why we exalt these people that we believe are great. We want them to have it. They've earned it.
Well, who else would you want to lead you?
This is so fucking idiotic, dude. Like, imagine trying to fucking defend meritocracy this hard, brother. People like Andrew Schultz and people like myself are living, breathing proofs that, like, meritocracy is kind of a fucking lie. I'm sorry, dude. It's just not real. No, it's just that, you know, people that are in positions of power deserve it. Why do they deserve it? Well, because they worked really hard. They're great. And they're doing greatness. It's true. You're just mauled. Okay, well, I guess you're admitting that I'm better than you then, if it's true. And I've worked harder and better than you in every meaning. I've I am just so much more important than you, then, I guess.
How do we discern between people who are mimicking greatness for power and greatness?
By paying careful attention, by listening, and by talking about it. That's the purpose of free speech. That's the purpose of political attention. Because you want the great, but it can be mimicked by, it's mimicked by psychopaths who use power. But that doesn't mean that power is the basis of our hierarchical human relationships. That's only the case when they've gone badly wrong. Well, when a society is corrupt, then the powerful rule. When a society isn't corrupt, then the great have authority.
I really do feel like Jordan Peterson just fucking lets out word vomit and just and people act like they understand what he's trying to say. Because I've lost the plot in its entirety. It doesn't feel like he has said anything. This is just an endless loop that he keeps closing over and over again. Every argument starts and ends at the same point. Like, literally everything he mentions is in its own fucking circuit, in its own closed loop. The great are great because they're great, and the powerful are powerful because they're powerful, and our institutions are actually wonderful because the greatness that derives from the power is led by the great and not the powerful, which would be corrupt, and institutions would be corrupt if the powerful were... The institutions would be corrupt if the powerful were not great. Okay, sick, dude. Please, give me $7 million to do a speaking tour now. Pepper in a couple self-help takes in here and take advantage of the fact that you have not had a positive male figure in your life.
And confusing those. You asked why the beta male is now this object of attention. It's because we've confused great and powerful. And now we're so afraid of power that we're willing to dispense with greatness entirely, or even to question whether it exists. That's the attack on the meritocracy.
Damn, you're really spitting, bro. Yo, you are spitting so hard, bro. Hell yeah, brother. You fucking really spitting, dude. Spit that hot fire, JBP. Bro, this motherfucker literally never even defined what greatness is. Like, I don't understand. He's just like, what is greatness in this argument? What is greatness in this conversation? He literally jumped from institutions are only corrupt if they're led by power and not greatness without fucking describing what greatness is. Like, I need him to define the terms that he is using.
There's no meritocracy. Oh, there's no greatness. And no one who has a position deserves it. There's no difference in talent. You made this distinction between greatness and power.
Yes.
So pursue it.
Okay.
How do you know someone's great as far as you're concerned?
Why is greatness and power mutually exclusive concepts? What are we looking at here? How do we get here from competence being a masculine trait?
You admire what's great if you have any sense.
Yeah.
Okay, and that happens spontaneously, especially in a domain that you value.
Yes, exactly. The more I value the domain, the more, God, I can't speak, the more, the more admiration.
More admiration.
I have. Absolutely. I do not admire power. I don't even care about people who are powerful if they don't have something that I admire, some sort of skill set that I care about. The only thing that's nice is like the ease of power. You can open up doors easier, you know, but I...
This is so fucking weird. How does this even answer why beta males became movie stars? It feels like this is a conversation between like two fucking undergrads who took an intro to philosophy course and are having a conversation that is really about like obvious generalizations that they're sitting there and pretending are like incredibly profound thoughts without actually digging deep into like the underlying reasons why they feel a certain way, for example. And you're watching it because you have nothing better to do? No, I actually literally have a bunch of things that are better to do. I'm watching it because I earnestly want to understand the underlying reasons to why people have such a profound loyalty to someone like Jordan Peterson. He's basically trying to say movie stars are beta males who mimic greatness and don't deserve the veneration they get. It's a pseudo-intellectual veneer to pretend they're not jealous of the actor's success. As long as you have deemed that the institutions themselves are not corrupt, but only corruptible by those who actually pretend to be great while they are simply just powerful by virtue of being powerful, then you have neatly tied a circle around the system of meritocracy that I deem to uphold. When in fact, the meritocracy is a lie, but I will never address that and make it seem as though the meritocracy is not a lie, but only bastardized by those who are corrupt. Why are they corrupt or bad? I will not address. I will just simply state that they are bad and that the values that I espouse are good. I'm not doing the Kermit voice. I'm simply channeling the dragon of chaos. Every time I talk about this, you fool. Western civilization is degenerating. And you are sitting over here asking me to not misgender a trans person. You fool, have you not thought about the dragon of chaos and what that makes me feel like? Absolutely not, I'll say. You pointed out a good point with defining terms. It's basic philosophy paper shit. If you're going to introduce terms key to an argument, you need to define them. It's really simple. And Peterson is unwilling to do that because he knows people can counter and poke holes in his argument if he does that. Yeah, but as long as he uses something that is like identifiable as a positive, like greatness, and as long as the counter to that is something negative, like I guess something that could be seen as negative, but also could be seen as positive, like power, then ultimately he sets the terms to mean whatever he wants them to mean at any given point, and he can literally change them up as he goes along.